Allegations of price gouging, domestic violence, even murder. Some blame the arrival of out-of-state drillers. Well, tonight, we're digging deeper into the natural gas boom.
Channel 4 Action News investigator Bofta Imam taps into underreported problems with our special report tonight. Bofta?
Mike, Wendy, there's no question the oil and gas industry has helped create jobs, but they're not hiring locals. Unfortunately, people from out of state mostly land the jobs. Tonight, we take a closer look at the social impact.
You can hear the wind in some sleepy parts of southwestern Pennsylvania. But after the gas industry drove in,
we figured we would settle because of the job opportunity my husband had.
Some say locals started getting pushed out.
There seems to be left a bad taste in a lot of the especially lower income individuals' mouths that they can't afford housing here anymore.
Greene County realtor Gwen Nicholson says the influx of oil and gas workers spiked the rental market, leading to price gouging. We found housing problems even sparked a Facebook page protesting greedy landlords in the Ohio Valley, gaining more than 900 likes.
Something that used to be, say, a $350 apartment is now probably closer to $700.
Our victims, when they leave an abusive situation, they need an affordable apartment.
Cheryl McCready with Domestic Violence Services of Western Pennsylvania says the domino effect of high rent could hit a dangerous ceiling. With local shelters packed, there's no room for new victims.
We've had more out-of-state victims come in. Many times a driller brings along a spouse or a girlfriend, and when they get into a domestic violence situation, they don't have any support system. They don't have the money to get back home.
In 2011, Greene County Protection from Abuse Orders reached 159, their highest peak in more than a decade. During the same year, 2,100 new victims surfaced in Greene, Fayette, and Washington counties.
Obviously, if it's something related to oil and gas, it's something that's going to catch my attention.
Washington County DA Eugene Vitone says he doesn't specifically track crimes committed by gas industry workers. However, he notes a steady increase of 700 criminal cases each year since the industry arrived in force 5 years ago.
That is attributable, I believe, to the rise of the heroin and prescription drug abuse in the county. Also, we have more people coming in because of the oil and gas industry, so we see DUIs associated with that and crimes associated with that.
We have seen an increase in alcohol-related offenses and aggressiveness.
He's the sheriff in Ohio County, West Virginia. When we compare 2009 to last year's crime statistics here, we found calls for emergency service nearly doubled to 13,000. Larceny increased more than 50% and criminal citations more than quadrupled. During the same period in Greene County, Pennsylvania, larceny crime spiked 50%. In Westmoreland, curfew and loitering jumped 55% and Fayette County drug abuse violations 20%.
That's, you know, scary to think you were next door, you know, just moved in next door to someone that's, you know, accused of murder.
While violent crimes don't happen often, these two out-of-state oil and gas industry workers were recently charged with second-degree murder. They're accused of the beating death of this Wheeling Jesuit University athlete and now face trial. But others, like gas worker Logan Lupardis, say he's a law-abiding citizen and says some locals drag the industry's rep into the mud. But he says it doesn't stick.
I see some people coming in for staying for a while. We have a couple moved here permanently, one from Louisiana, one from Texas.
And then they popped up.
Wheeling, Ohio County Health Department says school systems show signs of industry workers settling down too.
Families are now coming, and we saw an uptick in school immunizations.
As public services prep for the gas boom's extended stay.
Oh yeah, it's awesome. I love it here.
It's still unclear whether all of the locals in these small communities will wait out the friction.
It's kind of a crapshoot at this point.
Now, we just showed you the crime statistics in some counties, and again, no one is tracking at this time whether oil and gas workers have led to those increases. However, in Bradford County, their DA does say they've seen a 40% increase in criminal cases, mostly due to the gas industry. Bradford County has asked a Senate committee for more state police resources. We reached out to Marcellus Shale Coalition to get their take, but our calls were not returned. Live in the newsroom, Bofta Imam, Channel 4 Action News.